Daniel, thank you very much. My name's Daniel, I'm 23 years old. I studied for media college at Stanmore College, and I'm currently a documentary filmmaker. So a couple of years ago I done a documentary on Kiss Fast Food, Kid and Bridge Youth, and that was from my university dissertation. And now I'm currently working on a new documentary called Can We Help You For Less? So I'm basically making a sequel to my past documentary that I made. And at the moment I film and edit events as well, so I'm freelancing as well, kind of putting my hands into a lot of pies and making sure I'm busy, proactive. And I've also started up an initiative called Talk To Dad, which basically helps young people break into media through motivational events, which I'll explain to you a bit more later. So my first event will be on how to sell yourself on the CV. This will be followed up by how to maximize your online presence. So what I mean by how to sell yourself on a CV, a lot of people start their CV with just putting down, I'm motivated, I'm hardworking, I'm amazing, I want the job, I'm broke, give me the job. And the thing is, with the whole CV writing, I think what people don't understand is that they say all these things, but they forget to pee on the actual CV. And when we all learn English, GCSE, we were taught to give a point, example, and explanation. So if we're saying we're motivated, if we're saying we're hardworking, if we're saying we're determined, you know, positive, give an example, it could be within an industry you're working in, or it could just be within work, or just within life. So I've done quite a lot of work, that's at ITV, Sky, Channel 4. So all these places that you've seen me work at, you're probably thinking, oh, you know, it's amazing for me. I've been rejected so many times, and everyone hates rejection, but I believe in that. If you've been rejected 10 times, go the 11th time. It doesn't matter how many times you try, you're gonna definitely get it in the end. You have to be patient with things, you have to really believe in yourself as well, because one thing is that all this work since I've done, I believed in myself. I believed that I could get there, I believed that I could work in ITV. Use the power of visualization, so believe that you can work at great companies, big companies. I believe that I can work at Channel 4. I visualize myself sitting in the Channel 4 seat at ITV, stepping into Sky. I visualized it. When you start visualizing stuff, dreams can come true. And that's what we need to understand today. We need to have that power of visualization. Visualize that you can get to wherever you want to be. And this is exactly what I've done to get this work experience. My CV was a blank piece of paper. Just like how everyone starts off, it depends on you as a person to push yourself. What motivates you? What gets you out of bed every morning? Do you love what you do? Ask yourself that question. Are you doing enough with your days? We have 365 days in a year. What are you doing with your days? That's what you have to ask yourself. Are you doing enough? Look at what you're not doing. So we've had January, February, March. It's going to be April. We have 3 months that's gone away from us now. So think about things that you haven't done and kind of build that from the next month. When I was at Sky, I wanted to network, I wanted to meet people, I wanted to talk about what I was doing. I wanted to learn from people, I was willing to learn. Anything you do in life, doesn't matter if it's boring, exciting, always be willing to learn. You get a key skill, you learn something, you're building. Even if that's like retail or a job that you don't like, just always, don't take up for granted, basically. So whenever you're going to a company, understand that you're able to just learn of people, because so many people, they know a lot of things, and you have to understand that you want to learn of a lot of people. You know, everyone in here today, to me, is a contact because I've met you. So, you know, wherever you type is a card or not, everyone's a contact. You know, I treat everybody as a contact. You know, you have to understand that we have to all work together, build and actually understand that you can get to where you want to be, but we have to work as a team. And that's all it's about. This is stuff that I told young people when they need to leave. If you want to get into media, most important thing, and not even just media, just anything you do, get a contacts book. Like, I have my phone, I cracked it the other day, and if I put like one of you guys' contacts in there, I could lose my phone, and then your contact's gone. So I have my contacts book with me today, but it's just basically a notebook. That's all it is, a notebook. You write down the person's name, where you met them. So, who was your career event? I met them here. The day you met them, their role, and you have like a list of contacts, and you start building contacts, and you start to understand that this is about who you know, not what you know. That's what it's about leading up. So you have to understand that. Making sure you have like a LinkedIn and Twitter account as well. I think everything in terms of if I go to this here, I think everything in terms of with anything you do, have be on all social networks. So it'd be Twitter, LinkedIn, Instagram. I didn't even like Twitter, I said I hate Twitter because I never knew how to use it. But once you just understand how to use your social networks, you're able to just, you know, build yourself. So guys, understand that whenever you're in an industry, whatever you're doing, understand that you need to be going to the event today, like being here today, it's like a blessing for me because I'm meeting new people, I'm creating new opportunities. So events is really a great place to be. I still go to lots of events. But when I was looking for work experience, for the work experience that you see there, Channel 4, Sky TV, it's all amazing, but I was going to events, I wanted to get to know people. I wanted to know what I was doing. I told people what I was passionate about. I told people, you know, I want to become good at the camera. And once you tell people what you're passionate about, people start giving you a chance and can open doors for you, so be confident. These are key tips to take with you today, but before I go through some of them, I just want to say this main thing. I think this is something that's really going to touch me, but touch you guys as well. I know everyone knows this, but I didn't know Sharon's as well. There's no excuse to live up to your fullest potential. So in 2014, it was when I passed away. Yeah? And it was a very, very tough time for me. And the thing is that Mummy was there to see me graduate just a month before she passed away. So what I'm trying to say to you guys is that as much as you have to obviously come to terms with things that's happened, and it can be anything you're going through, you know, mental health or just anything, there's always someone to talk to, be strong and you have to come to terms with things. So understand that there should be no excuses for anything to your full potential. Like, you have to understand that you have to always come to terms with things. I mean, it's been, I'm coming to 3 years now, I've passed away, but I feel that I can motivate people through my work. I can help them and get them to where they need to be, give them those key skills. It's important because a lot of people always ask me, how the hell can you actually stand up here and do this and try and motivate people when you also know what you've been through? And I said to them, I'm a strong person, I want to be a strong person and to build myself and to go out there and teach people, you know, that they can get to where they want to be. I used to always talk to my mum in the kitchen about just anything. I'd talk for days and motivate and tell her, you know, look, this is what I want to do. And she looked at me like, hey, no, you should be a lawyer. I said, no, I'm going to be a filmmaker. That's what I want to be, not a lawyer. But yeah, my mum believed in me. And that's the main thing people need to, if you want people to believe in you, you've got to believe in yourself. That's the main thing. Believe in yourself, believe in your talent. I said, do it now, sometimes later comes never. If you think about what you're doing, if you don't do it now, sometimes you're just going to procrastinate and it's never going to happen for you. You know, you could have something, a clever idea, and you think to yourself that, you know, you're not going to get to where you want to be. Look, my mom's gone now. Yeah, my mom's gone. We need to all step up and understand that today you can make a change. If it's you, you know everybody here, when you're meeting a new person, grab a contact. Do something, do what you love. Everyone can do what they want in this world, but you want to do what you love, and that's the most important thing. Let's understand that today, because in the end, I'm doing what I love. I love talking, I love creating, I love directing, that's what I do. You know, and a lot of people say, what do you actually do? Because there's so many things you do, whether it's a speaker or a filmmaker, etc. But I love creating, I love directing, I love talking to young people, motivating them, giving them help. That's what I love doing. You don't have to be great to start, you have to start to be great. So you know, a lot of us young people, I feel sometimes we're a bit laid back. We're very lackadaisical, we can come a bit relaxed. We're the future, we have to understand that. We have to really push ourselves to get to where we want to be. You know, everyone sitting here today has a dream. I have a dream. I haven't hit that dream yet. I've done a lot of amazing things, I can thank God for that. You know, all praise to God, but you have to understand that if you want to get to where you want to be, you have to just strive and push, sleep late nights, work on your craft, be great at what you do, because there's someone else there doing the same thing, and if they're doing it ordinarily, then obviously, you know, the company's going to pick them over you. So, yeah, this is one thing, you know, I'll say now, you're not procrastinating, it's just not priority. So, I don't believe in procrastination too much because, you know, if you really want to get something done, you'll get it done anyway. You know, don't, if you have, you know, have priorities, so, you know, if your priority is to basically get something done within that week, get it done. And then obviously you can, you know, go reap your rewards after, you know, go play your PlayStation or go football with your boys or go do your nails with girls and all that kind of stuff. You know what I mean? But understand that there's key things that are important to do first. You know, you need to know your priorities. Do one thing every day that scares you. And what I mean by that, I don't mean go rob a car. I don't mean go rob a bank. Do one thing every day that you feel that, you know, I can't do this, and you'll be surprised of the outcome. Because relating to me, I was very nervous when I stepped into the industry because it's a very broad industry. There's a lot of it, and you have to understand that when you step into something that you're nervous about, it takes you time to become confident. As soon as I stepped into it, I built confidence, I went to events, I started telling people what I wanted to do, and from there, the nerves went. You know, there's still times when I feel like I'm not at my peak yet. You know, I'm still learning a few things. Every day we're still learning new things. And one of the main things I wanted to say is that some people want sleep more than they want success. A lot of us love sleep. We love sleep. We'll lay until like midday. Yeah, we'll have our rest. It's good to rest. But at the same time, I'm a person. Look, if A is waking up at 9 a.m. and if B's waking up at midday, well, who do you think is going to get the job? Who do you think is going to get the opportunity? You know what I mean? So just be serious about what you're doing. Like, understand that you need to push yourself to the limit. You know, everyone's got a dream in here, and I know everyone in this town. I don't know everyone doesn't here. I know obviously some things what people are doing here, but everyone's got a talent, and I hate it when I hear young people say I'm a talent, because it doesn't make sense to me, you know? And obviously, in the media industry, you know, we're overlooked, of course, you know, but they obviously open up more black, Asian, minority, ethnic, opportunities. But the main thing, we've got to do a bit more. That's the thing, we've got to show them what we've got. And the vision with no action is just a dream. So my vision, I want to become a director, a filmmaker, creator, but also motivate people through my work. Everyone has a vision. You know, you might want to become a fashion designer, you might want to become a businessman, or whatever, but are you doing the few things that you need to do to get to where you want to be? Are you waking up every single day and saying, okay, I want to be business, but I've got business cards? Or have you even written down a business plan? Or, you know what I mean? So the key things you need to do to get to where you want to be, are you doing those things? Everyone can shout a lot of things. I'm going to have a big house, I'm going to have a big car, I'm going to, do this, do that, but you haven't even got the license yet, and you're saying all these things. Do you know what I mean? So, if you're shouting all these things, do something about it, put action to what you're saying. So contact me, I have a business card with somebody anyway, which is the number, to contact me through my LinkedIn, Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook, and that is my email. I have my business cards anyway, which I can give out again. If you have any questions, right now I can take questions. Can you give a big clap to Daniel? Come on, that is from me, the top of the team, that is a massive clap. Hey Daniel, he's coming to college. He used to be a shy person, so it's actually inspiring to someone, so inspiring that can actually motivate people. So, before we invite Inka to speak to us, we're going to have questions. We're going to take questions. Is there anyone that has any questions for Daniel? Yes.
What I was going to ask is, when did you know this is what you want to do? And yeah, when?
So, me talking to Dan just basically, We talked about this, I figured out I wanted to do that last year summer, but I was very occupied with work. I didn't have the time to sit down and actually plan a lot of things. And then I said to myself, I'm going to take a risk and go my own way and start talking to Dan. When I started talking to Dan, in January this year, so it is fairly new. And I started on the 10th of January, so it's been 2 months and a bit. Built a lot of followers on Instagram, built a lot of followers on Twitter, and through Facebook as well. But when I started talking to Dan, he just started talking to that page, and I said, you know, I'm going to start putting pictures and putting things that I've done to motivate young people into getting into media and to show them that, you know, you've got to start from the bottom. You've got to start as a runner, and you've got to understand that you have to make your way into media in some sort of way. If it be you grabbing a camera and filming your own little things, or just going to a company, being a runner, and then going up.
And when did you know you wanted to be a filming company? Like, have you always wanted to be a filming?
Nah, I haven't always wanted to be a filmmaker. I wanted to be a personal trainer, not gonna lie, from when I was about 16, like when I was in like college, everyone wanted to be a personal trainer. I done PE, so when I failed it, I was like, you know what, I'm not gonna tell you what grade I got. But when I failed it, I was like, oh, you know, like that dream's gone. But then when I started watching lots of films, like at home, I was watching Harry Potter, I'm a big Harry Potter fan. I might sound really nerdy, but oh, I love Harry Potter. I loved Harry Potter, and I just kept watching it, and I watched all of this sort of sequels, and I was like, you know what, to be honest, I love the way things are filmed. When I was watching all these films, like, people were watching at home, and they said, and I kept like critiquing it, and they were saying, can you just chill the critique and stop critiquing, just watch the film. Like, and I was like, look, I'm critiquing for a reason, because I love film. It's like, yeah, but just do that after your own little time. So I kept critiquing, and I was just really intrigued on how things are done within the media. And I said, no, I want to start doing film and media. And then, as soon as I grabbed the camera, I was like, you know what, this is just amazing. This is me. This is what I want to do, to create and, you know, get people to love what's seen in the film. So that's exactly what I wanted to do.
A point you made about trying to buy a house and have a car and still don't have a license. How do you kind of be proactive, like when you, obviously you're talking about having a license, so that's the first thing you do first before you actually have a car.
Mm.
In terms of career-wise, how do you kind of be proactive to search outside the box to actually get to that height that you're trying to get to? Can you just explain that?
Yeah, so to be proactive where you want to get to, think about why you first started. So there's a reason for why you started. The reason for why you wanted to get to where you wanted to get to where you want to be, and understand that you started for a reason. So I started to stand for a reason. I'm not going to stop because I want to build it. I want to motivate young people. So you have to understand the reasons why you start things. You got a license for a reason to obviously get to the end goal, which is to obviously get the car. You got a mortgage for a reason to get to the end goal, to get a house, for example. So always understand why you started, the reason why you started, and that's the most important point here.
What I'd like to ask you is, during your presentation you said that you've been rejected several times. What I want to know, and you know, what I'd like you to, you know, tell young people and the youth that says, what do you do when you've been rejected several times? Do you, you know, like, what do you do to build yourself up again and to put yourself, you know, and to keep going? Because I know rejection is very difficult for some people to handle. So can you please tell us so people will be motivated as well? Thank you.
If you're, you know, when you get rejected, it feels like the worst in the world. You just fall at the bottom of the ground. You feel like you can't get back up again. But what you have to understand is that you started for a reason. You know, you applied, you failed, you applied, you failed, you applied, you failed. Every single thing that you do, you have to understand that there's potentially a possibility that there could be failure. You know, that everything, you're not going to get everything. And that's what I understood as well. Like, when I went into a lot of things that I'd done, I understood that potentially I could fail. But I believe that at least if I tried, I know what the outcome is. to feel rejected, understand why you first started, but also understand that, have that inner belief in yourself, you know, get yourself back up again, and, you know, if it be even just reading quotes, because quotes are what gets me going. And I know that sounds probably a bit like, I was quoting you, but quotes, and just, you know, doing something that interests you, so even doing like a favorite pastime, you know, if it's just going out and just, you know, playing football, or just doing something that you enjoy and have fun with, and then get you back up again on the road to where you need to be. Just believe in yourself, understand why you first started. You started for a reason. If you fell 10 times, have that inner belief in yourself that you can do it again, and do it again, and do it again. It's just about you being confident in yourself, because once you just stop, you're not going to get to where you want to be.
Yeah, I'm going to take two more questions. I've got Harry, Daniel, and Audrey, and Sam.
Majority of things that I've got on my work, on my CV, is through applying online and getting an opportunity. I had to wait sometimes to get an opportunity, so I fell, but I get it in the end, because I kept believing. But some places, I went to events. So if you guys download Eventbrite, it's really good, because it kind of looks into different sectors, so media, fashion, whatever they be, and free events. And I go to these kind of events to meet people, to be inspired by people, and also to understand what people are doing. And through those events, I can meet someone and potentially tell them what I'm doing, and give me an opportunity. So that's one thing as well. When you can, I've met people at an event, and basically, you know, say, oh, I'm a producer, I'm doing this, okay, well, I'm this, I'm a runner. And they'll be like, okay, I need you on the shoot. And then that's what happens to bring straight there, exchanging contact. So one thing as well was a through event, but at the same time, just having that, you know, confidence to apply online as well, even if the application stage is 2 hours, 3 hours, and there's so many questions, but you've got to get through it if you really want it.
I know you're here to encourage us, but I'd like to encourage you, because it's always nice when you see someone you know up on the stage here. Yeah? Yeah. I've got a two-part question. One of them is, in your field, who are your role models, and what about your work or who they are encourages you to do what you're doing? All right. And the second one is, what are some of the misconceptions about media? Because you hear all these sort of things that it's like, you know, we're here, we are. So to put it, yeah, religious people, yeah, but what comes out of the media is not always, you know, what is good for people that are so-called believers. Yeah. What are some of the misconceptions you found in that field, and how do you go around that?
So the first question on my people that I'm motivated by, I'd say Eric Thomas, the motivation speaker, and person within, I'm motivated by a good director of the film, is James Cameron. Looking at their films, just the way they directed it, the way they put together their storylines, just about having the idea as well, which is amazing. And with Eric Thomas as well, he's a motivational speaker. I look at his videos, they're really motivating. He kind of gets me amped up as well, and also just allows me to believe that I can motivate young people. With your second question, I have to repeat it again, just so I understand it.
It's misconceptions within the media industry.
So do you mean in terms of like, if it be a film, like, what like meaning behind like a music video or something like that, or stuff like that?
Well, yeah, a music video. How does someone that has been brought up, that you don't see, I don't watch much TV, so I don't know, the music channels, you don't see like a gospel song on there, for example, yeah? How does someone that has been brought up in the church or something like that go out there and make it as a musician or a movie star without having to, you know, let go of some of the ethics that they grew up with?
It's the thing, like, there's all these rules and certain things you've got to follow, like, with the music industry anyway, like, the way it is now is about sex, money, drugs, and unfortunately, that's what it's about, like, that's what sells. It's what sells, so, like, people are looking at, like, the certain things that sells is what's going to get people watching and actually looking at these things, so, unfortunately, it's always going to stay like that. Unless someone has a different way of doing it, but and obviously at the moment the way it is, that's what's getting people to watch it, that's what's getting people to engage and understand that that's the way it's going to go.
Hi, my question is, towards the end of your presentation, you spoke about the media industry you look down upon, or not being taken as seriously as some of the other issues. For people who want to get into the media industry, I think it is an industry that's kind of not seen as the most fruitful industry. So, and a lot of, I guess, parents would question their children getting into the media industry. How would you, you know, tackle that side of that? Like, if you don't get support from your family members?
I think I know you're touching upon here, because a lot of us probably like come from like an African, Jamaican, Nigerian kind of background, and a lot of our parents are like, you know, my mom wanted me to become like a lawyer, because I could talk for days, talk when I was in dishes, talk when I was whatever, do you know what I mean? But for them to believe in what you do, and for them to believe that where you want to go, you have to explain the reason why you're doing it, explain it to them. Tell them, you know, this is what I'm doing, this is what I'm passionate about. I think this is a problem. Like, a lot of people are going to university and they're doing things that they really don't want to do. Their parents are more or less, and I'm like, these teachers do that. And I had a lot of friends like that. And I said to my friend, you know, I went to uni, I got a job, that's what I wanted to do. If you're not doing something you're passionate about, you're not going to give you 110% of it. So you have to not say persuade your parents, like, yeah, you know, I'm going to do this and I'm going to make amazing money, so you know, believe in this and this is going to go amazing. But you have to tell them that this is my passion. They have to really get that instilled in them, like, this is my passion, what I want to do. My passion is not to become a doctor, no, my passion is to become a creator, you know. And all good doctors and lawyers and stuff, but not every person has to be that, you know. If you want to be something different, be different, you know. You might want to be an author because you're good at writing. You know, do you know what I mean? So I think the parents just have to believe in you, and they should believe in your passion. You know, if you can show that you're getting to believe in the passion, show that this is what I'm doing, this is the steps. Even if you say, I don't want to go uni, I want to start from ground up, grab a camera and do this, take that risk. I've taken risks, you know, you have to take risks in life. And I think it's my parents believe in that. It's going to take time for them to believe it, to get to that point, but you just have to believe in what your passion is. That's amazing.
Thank you very much. Thanks for your great talk. My question is about talk to them.
Yeah.
And obviously it's a start. You said that you only started in January.
Yeah.
And I just want to know, have you identified a lot and you are aware of any challenges from the media perspective that comes with startups? Obviously you just started now, and we know what challenges regarding startups and other industries. But from your media perspective, as you're talking about rules and regulations, that limits what you can actually do. So what are some of the challenges and how do you plan to tackle them?
In terms of challenges of what I'm doing, talk to them, it's more or less about one of the most difficult things I've kind of experienced is getting out there, getting people to get to know about what talk to them actually is, and understanding that, you know, it's a lot of people think it's an advisor thing, is it a motivational event thing, and just kind of breaking it down and saying it's me advising young people, giving them those key skills that they need to gain opportunities in the media. I've understood that a lot of companies will look at my talk to them and understand that what I'm doing is great, but they potentially have people within that company that are doing the same thing anyway. But the difference with me is that this event will just be basically talking to you guys, but these events will basically be, you know, they'll be motivational, but at the same time, I'm going to get young people to be engaged, have their own activities, and games as well involved with the motivational events I do. Because young people, that's how you can get young people engaged during an event, so they don't feel disengaged, if that makes sense. And there's a lot of things I still need to think about in terms of getting out there, funding as well, because potentially I want to push and do seminars for next year, for starting events for September 2017 onwards, but seminars pushing that, so getting people to become hands-on, if it be learning the camera, if it be editing, so there's a lot of things I have to think about as well.
Okay, that was the last question. Once again, please give a big thank you to Daniel. A bigger one, please. We need some people, though. It's a big one.